My name is Maria McLafferty. McLafferty comes from my husband, whom I married. I met him in Poland. I was born and brought up in Poland. And I studied English and art at the Warsaw Academy of Art. From Warsaw, I moved to India, and we lived for a couple of years in India. I did a lot of painting there. I used to do big oils. And then I moved to England, where I started to do printmaking. I became a printmaker for quite a long time, with sort of some successes, because some big galleries bought the whole editions of my prints. And then being in England, in London, I discovered stained glass, and that altered my vision completely, and I started working with glass, and that was it. Once I started to work with glass, I couldn't move into any other medium. Eventually I decided to come here because I like Grenada. I love the climate. Not that it looks now because it's so hot, so I'm a little bit too hot, but I basically like the weather and love the sea and love Grenada. I came here at the end of 1999, so I've been here for 9 years now, and I am very happy to be here. When I came to Grenada first, I had quite a big commission. I was working for the St. George's Cathedral. I restored one of the old stained glass panels which was there, which was a very beautiful old stained glass from 19th century, from one of the Birmingham studios. And I was extremely happy to be doing that. It was quite a laborious job, but it was successfully finished and installed. And then I was commissioned to do another work for St. George's Cathedral, and that was the Black Madonna, which I almost finished. Unfortunately, there was about two or three panels still to be finished, and then hurricane came and destroyed everything, including the stained glass restored windows and my new window. I also did, before the hurricane, I also did some work for the church in St. David's, which also had been destroyed. And so most of my work that I have done before the hurricane was destroyed, but because even private homes where my work was installed got blown down and lost. Well, I also was blown down here and sort of partially lost, but I managed to recover. And when I recovered, I started to do jewelry. It's an instant delight, and it is an instant return, because when people come and tell me that they like the pieces I've made, I get a lot of kick out of it, and it gives me encouragement to go and do more. Since the hurricane, I was also quite fortunate to do quite a few larger commissions, not just jewelry. There is a big screen which in Villa Magnet, which separate the sitting area from dining area. It's got quite a lot of panels. I never remember the numbers, so I can't tell you how many, but it took a long time to do, and this is all done with the process of fusing glass. I also fused metal into glass, and there are a few panels there where I fused metal to represent vegetation under the sea. The whole screen is based on life under the surface of the water. I started to do scuba diving, and that was quite fortunate that I could see those beauties under the sea, and then I tried to reproduce it in glass. It was quite a challenging work, but on the whole, the screen works. the series of Arawak gods. And this really started, this interest in gods started during the hurricane, where I was sitting in my studio, because that was the only place where I still had the roof on, and not knowing exactly what's going to happen and whether that's going to be blown too. It became very of great interest to me, and I in fact did a big sculpture. I was invited to go to China as a representative of Grenada, where I did the sculpture of Zemi. And Zemi was a god which was represented by a conch, and it was the god of the volcano and of the weather. And the first people here were praying to this god, because they couldn't, like, well, very much like us, they couldn't understand all the elements that surround us, this very beautiful and peaceful landscape being torn away by either erupting volcano or a hurricane or something of that nature. So Zemi was the god to which they prayed. And I did this, in China I did this big conch, which is over 2.5 meters in one direction, in all directions, because it's virtually round, it's a three-dimensional object, which is now placed in the park. It's in Changchun, in the biggest sculpture park in China. Unfortunately, I didn't have chance to go and see it permanently installed, because it was this year, and I just didn't manage to get there. That also moves me to the other pieces that I have done in glass here, which are devoted to the Caribbean gods. I have portrayed the goddess of fertility in many ways, which is one of my favorite subjects. In the triptych that you are seeing, there are three gods. There's the Trinity, with the middle panel being devoted to the goddess of fertility. Which is in the same building where I have my triptych. It was commissioned to me to commemorate memory of a very great man who used to live in Grenada, and it is entitled Sunrise.